Greetings in the name of Yahweh, the only name given among men whereby we must be saved. And we do appreciate each and every one of you who has taken your time tuning in this program. And we believe it'll be a real blessing to you. At the end of the broadcast, we'll give you an address, telephone number, how to receive information. We have a CD that's called The Father's Name. We also have a CD that's called True Oneness. And the literature that we send out with both of them. Matter of fact, we'll give you the website to how you can go on and look at more material and videos. We're going to go over to the book of Matthew 1:23. Then we're going to go to the book of Isaiah. But right before we do, I would like to read in the book of Romans, chapter 1, starting in verse 5. Usually, as we say every week, we're reading from a red letter edition King James Bible. And you can check this out for yourself, that the name of Jesus is not in the original 1611 King James Bible. It is the IESUS, known as Jesus, and it goes back to the Greek IESOUS, which is known as Jesus. So what you have Greek Jesus, then you have just the Latin, I guess, or ever word it would be, IESUS, or Greek Latin, Jesus. Then, I guess, a mixture of Greek, Latin, and English when it comes into the 1769, known as Jesus. So you've got three different names in translation. So then, if that be true, and ain't no if it is, you can find this for yourself. Then the name of Jesus could not have been used in the original early assembly. And the truth, the Bible says you'll know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Now, this has nothing to do with your experience. Because when you start doing any studying, and you go back to church history, and you have three different names, and neither one of those names, Jesus, Jesus, and Jesus, was ever used in the early assembly as being the Messiah's name. And I want to make that clear. That Messiah did not come, first of all, he did not come in the name of Joshua, or what would be known in Hebrew as Yehoshua. And then it was more as it went on, it was changed, the Yehoshua was changed to Yeshua. But none of these names were the name of the Messiah. The Messiah had to come in his Father's name. And that's the bottom line. Here in the book of Romans 1 and 5, we read this last week. It says, by whom we have received grace and apostleship for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name. Now, when you read this and really understand it, first of all, this has nothing, when it talks about the name here, this has nothing to do with any other name other than the name of Yahweh. This has nothing to do with the name of Yeshua. Yeshua, or some will say Yahshua, or Jesus, or Jesus, or Jesus, or any other name. There's only one name that was given to the early assembly. You keep this in mind. The Apostle Peter, who had the keys to the kingdom, walked with the Messiah, had the keys to the kingdom, and the first name that he gave for the plan of salvation was the name of Yahweh. It was no other name. Now, going over to the book of Matthew 1:21, then I want to go over to the book of Isaiah. The book of Matthew 1:21 says, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. Is totally ruled out. Jesus is totally ruled out. Jesus is totally ruled out. Yeshua is totally ruled out. Yehoshua is totally ruled out. There's only one name that can fulfill these verses that we're fixing to talk about. I'm probably going to deal and discuss this book of Isaiah 7:14 and the book of Matthew 1:21 down to 1:23 totally different than any way you've ever heard it. But I'm going to deal with it according to the scripture, reading a King James Bible. Now, we're like everybody else. We can go to words such as used like a Strong's. I guess I don't use a Strong's a whole lot per se. I think Strong's is real good because what it does, Strong's usually give you the root words, especially in Hebrew, the root words. Of Hebrew words. So we're going to be dealing back and forth with different Hebrew words. But we're going to be using the King James Bible to prove this. But it goes on, it says, for he shall, it says, name. Of course, the King James says Jesus. It's impossible. For he shall save his people from their sins. Any other name here other than the name of Yahweh will not fit. All right, going over to the book of Isaiah 7:14. That's Isaiah 7:14. I hope that you can get your Bibles and study along with us. I hope that there's something that we can say that will encourage you to study. If you'll take your Bibles and study along with us, there's no way you're going to say that we've got on this radio broadcast and have totally distorted the Word of Yahweh. If you will stay with your Bible, you will have to agree with what your Bible says. And it's impossible that your writing New Testament could have the name of Jesus in it, and you believe that that Messiah was Yahweh Almighty in a robe of flesh. Now, if you're oneness, you should really have no problem with this. And if you're Trinity, you should really have no problem with this. Because it is talking about a name. Isaiah 7:14 says, therefore, the Lord Himself. Now, I got into this a little bit last week in Isaiah 7:14 here. And I don't want to really spend a lot of time on this here. But right here where it uses the word Lord. This is in small letters, all but the L. L is in capital letters, but the word O-R-D is in small letters. In Hebrew script, from where the King James Bible was translated from, this word Lord is the Hebrew word for Adonai. When you look up the word, matter of fact, you can take a Strong's Concordance. A Strong's Concordance will tell you it's the Hebrew word Adonai. This word Adonai actually usually means my Lord. It is come from a root word that's known as Adon, which means Lord, Master, and so forth. So here in this particular word in 7:14, it uses the word Lord, L-O-R-D, but the O-R-D is in small letters. So you need to take notice to some of this. So it says, therefore, the Lord Himself, or the Hebrew word Adonai, Himself, shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and call his name Immanuel. Matter of fact, while I'm here, I'm going to deal with this real quick. The word for virgin here is a Hebrew word that's called Alma. You'll hear a lot of people that does not believe in a virgin birth will try to twist this word up. But this word here actually means a virgin as a young woman or newly married is what it would say. Now we understand that Joseph, when he had taken Mary or Miriam, and he had already done took her as wife, but he did not know her. This is pretty much the same way this word is used. And he was going to put her away privately. But then that's when the angel of Yahweh visited him in a dream. and told him what was going on. But he was a just man, and he was going to put her away privately because she was an Alma, a young woman. She had not known a man. So a lot of people will take this and twist this word up and try to make it that she could be a virgin and known a man, but that's not so. Now there is a Hebrew word that's known as betulah. But again, if you will study this out, search this, you will find that that Mashiach was virgin born. I would be scared of anyone that said that that Messiah was not virgin born. Because if the Mashiach was not virgin born, then he would have had to have someone to die for him. Because Yahweh could not use the bloodline of Adam. Because Adam's sin. And this is why the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, is what had come on Miriam, or Mary, and she conceived. And that was in her was holy. But it goes on and it says, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and call his name. The Hebrew word name here is the word Shem. Shall call his name, the King James says, Emmanuel, Immanuel. But the Hebrew word is Immanuel. Now, give you something to study on. This word in Hebrew, where you see the King James has the word Immanuel, they have got it put together. They've got it put together as a name. They got it put together all together. It's together here. But in the Hebrew script, it's totally separated. In Hebrew script, it would be like taking. Let me give you an example about something here. It would be like taking the word Immanuel. And separating the Immanu from the word El. In other words, make it easy on you. If you're where you can write this down, when you see the word I, or what the King James says, Immanuel, spelled Immanuel. If you will take and write this on a piece of paper, but only write Immanu, then separate it, like you're going to go to another word, then write El. And when you do, you find this is actually how it would be written in Hebrew. You would find it written like this. The first letters, Immanu, is a Hebrew word called, which actually means with us. In Hebrew, it would be said, Imanu. It means with us. Then, the other part that you have separated from it, you have the E-L, that's the word El in Hebrew, which is the word for God. So in the English, you would read it this way. With us is God. That's really, truthfully, how it should have been written in your Bible. And it's a big possibility that in some translations that it is written like that. I said it's a big possibility that in some translations that it would be written like that. And you can probably find it in some translations. So a lot of times, if you'll take time and study some of this, because listen, this whole Bible is about one thing. It's about the Creator of heaven and earth that has a name. And His name has been hidden from you, from the church. It's sad, but it has been. I said it's sad, but it has been. You're being taught that nobody knows His name. You're being taught that nobody can say it. Nobody can write it. And it makes no sense. When Apostle Peter himself on the day of Pentecost give witness to a name that the church is being taught against. Jesus is not old enough for the early assembly. Jesus is not old enough. Jesus was never the Mashiach's true name. There's not but one true name that Messiah come in. And that was His Father's name. And that is the name that we're in search for right now by reading these verses. Again, I want to read 7:14. It says, therefore, the King James says, the Lord Himself, or it's the Hebrew word Adonai, Himself, which is talking about the Creator of heaven and earth here. People today will take the word Adonai, make it a name. And it's not. But it says, the Lord Himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call His name, King James says, Emmanuel. Hebrew is the Hebrew word called Immanuel. But if you'll take the word Emmanuel, when you're looking at it, separate the E-L from the rest of it, that is really how it's written in the Hebrew script from where the King James was translated from. Now, we're looking at this, and I'm going to ask you a question. Do you really believe that it says call His name Emmanuel? Before we go any farther, and I don't even know how far I'm going to be able to get in this broadcast because of time, because there's so much to it, and I said last week that I really want to take my time and go through this. Take the word Emmanuel. Let's look up and see how many times the word Emmanuel, I-M-M-A-N-U-E-L, is in the Old Testament. We find it twice. It's in the book of Isaiah 7:14, where we're just reading. also in the book of Isaiah 8:8. You can find this yourself. So, in both places, in Hebrew, it is the Hebrew word called Immanuel, and they're separated. And again, if you will write down the word Immanuel, but separate the E-L with a space, then that will give you some understanding how in the Hebrew language, of course, Hebrew is going to read from right to left. But in the Hebrew scripture, that's how it would be read. And remember the word Immanu means, or what the King James would spell, I-M-M-A-N-U, would be the word with us. Matter of fact, if you take the word with us, if you went over to Genesis 31:50, Exodus 10:25, and the word Exodus 20:19, when you see the word with us in all three of those verses, in the King James Bible in English, this is the same identical Hebrew word, Immanu. Only difference is it doesn't have the L to it. It's just saying Immanu, with us, with us, with us. Then when the EL is added, it's saying with us is God. Then I'm going to ask you the question again. Do you really believe that this was his name? I said, do you really believe that this was his name? It looks like that our time is, or has, just about come and gone. We're going to try to deal with this again next week. And next week, we're going to deal with a little bit on Jehovah. Because we're being taught that God doesn't have nobody knows his name. Nobody can write it. Nobody can say it. And the church has failed for it through traditions and doctrines of men. But the early assembly knew the true name of the creator of heaven and earth. We have literature, and we have a CD called The Father's Name, and we have a CD called True Oneness. And, of course, the literature that was sent out along with it. You can write Brother Jerry, 775 MacDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. That's Brother Jerry, 775 MacDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. That's Brother Jerry, 775 MacDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. Telephone number is 770-784-0703. That's 770-784-0703. We have a website. To go to our website, you can see some of the videos that we've got up. You can, to go to it, you have to spell Yahweh this way. YAHWAH, then a hyphen, ministries.org. That's YAHWAHministries.org. Spell Yahweh, YAHWAH, a hyphen, ministries.org. And it should take you right over there, Woodsack. Telephone number, once again, is 770-784-0703. That's 770-784-0703. Address, once again, is Brother Jerry, 775 MacDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. Telephone number, once again, 770-784-0703. We come on at this same time every week. We hope that you'll call someone up and tell them we're on the air. So till the next broadcast, same time. We appreciate you. We love you. Shalom.